Good morning, students. So today I will start with reflection. You know what is light? Light is a form of energy, okay, which produces the sensation of vision. Okay, form of energy which produces the sensation of vision. Like, you know, heat is a form of also energy. So similarly, light is also a form of energy which produces the sensation of vision. Okay, that is a property of light that is called the reflection. Okay, so what is reflection? I say reflection is the bouncing back of light after striking a surface. Okay, bouncing back of light. Okay, so before starting the laws of reflection, I want to say some terms, some important terms. Acha, so first, acha, you know, suppose consider this is a mirror, plane mirror. What is this? This is a plane mirror. You know, there are also spherical mirrors. So in your class I will only discuss with plane mirror, huh? I will discuss only about plane mirror. Okay, so see, the surface is plane, that's why it is called the plane mirror. And listen, what is mirror? One surface is polished and another surface, I mean the back surface, is silvered. It is silvered. Okay, it is silver. That's why light can't reach to the reach to the next medium. Okay, light cannot pass through it. So after light after striking, light return to the same medium. So it's such a, what is reflection? What it is a bouncing back of light to the same medium after striking a surface. So suppose this is a surface, this is a surface, and what it is bouncing back. So suppose this is the air medium, this is the air medium, that means light, the mirror is placed on the ground and it is the air medium. So if light comes and strike and reach this medium, so this is also air medium, here air, nothing means air. So light comes from the air medium and after reflection it returns back to the air medium. That's why it is called the reflection. Air medium se aya, fir se air medium mein wapas chala gaya. Okay. Acha. Acha. If you see in a book, it has started with incident ray. Okay. But I will start with normal. So what is normal? What did I say? What is normal? Normal is a perpendicular line drawn on the surface. So suppose I am drawing a perpendicular means what actually? Perpendicular means the angle between this and this is 90 degree. That is, this angle is 90 degree or this angle is also 90 degree. Okay, so this is called the normal. Here the normal has the very much important. Okay, students. Acha, next, incident ray. What is incident ray? Incident ray means the ray which strikes. Acha, first, incident ray, the ray which strikes. Okay. Suppose this is the ray which strikes the mirror surface. Acha, what did I say? One thing I have told you, that here ray direction is very important. So I have to give the ray direction. So this is the incident ray. That means incident ray means the ray which strikes the surface. Okay. Next, point of incidence. The ray strikes at this point. So this point is called the point of incidence. Oh, this is incident ray. This point is called point of incidence, where the incident light strikes, or the incident ray strikes the mirror or strike the surface, is called point of incidence. Okay, and we have to draw the normal at the point of incidence. Why have I drawn the normal before? Because just the page was very clean, that's why first I have drawn the normals for my easy. Okay, nothing but first I have to draw the incident ray, and at the, and where the incident ray strikes, that point is called point of incidence. okay. Now we have to draw the normal at the point of incidence. Okay. Next, after striking, it will return to the initial medium or the original medium. So this is the reflected ray. This is reflected ray. Reflected ray means this is reflected ray. Reflected ray means which reflects after striking the reflecting surface. This is called the reflecting surface. This is also called the reflecting surface. This is called the reflecting surface. Okay. So understood. Incident ray, the ray which comes and strikes the mirror or surface, reflecting surface, is called the incident ray. At that point, the ray strikes is called point of incidence. After reflection, light goes to the original medium or initial or the first medium again. That ray is called the reflected ray. And at the point of incidence, we draw a perpendicular line. That is called the normal. Okay. Now we will discuss about angle of incidence and angle of reflection. What is angle of incidence? What is angle of reflection? One thing you have to remember, or you have to remember very carefully, all the angles for reflection, angles are measured with normal. Angles are measured with normal, not with the reflecting surface. I am telling again and again, the angles are not measured with reflecting surface. The angles are measured with normal. So what is angle of incidence? The angle between incident ray, angle of incidence. So wo angle kiske sath honge? Incident ray ke sath, normal ka. So what is the angle of incidence? Angle of incidence is the angle between incident ray and the normal. This angle is called the angle of incidence. So here I is the angle of incidence. And the angle subtended by the reflected ray with the normal is called the angle of reflection. Clear? So here I is the angle of incidence, R is the angle of reflection. So what did I say? Again, I am telling, the all the angles are measured with normal. I is the angle between incident ray and normal. Not the angle is not made with the surface. Okay. And here see, the angle of reflection is measured with the reflected ray and normal. Okay. So I hope this for all the terms are clear. Incident ray, reflected ray, point of incidence, normal, angle of incidence, angle of reflection. Okay, now I will discuss laws of reflection. So first law, first law says the incident ray, first I am telling the statement, incident ray, the normal drawn at the point of incidence, and the reflected ray, they all lie in the same plane. That means this incident ray, this normal, and the reflected ray lie in a same plane. Just consider this is the mirror surface, so what is there in above my hand? Obviously it is space. Above my hand, there is space. So if I consider this is the reflecting surface, my hand is reflecting surface, and all the rays are coming from this space. So here you see, here we have two planes. One is my hand plane. Another plane is ground plane, or another plane is from where the light comes, from where the light comes, because that is space. So space plane. So incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal. If this is the, if the our hand or if my hand is in the ground plane, then incident ray, normal, and reflected ray, all the rays must be in the space plane. देखो दे ऑल लाई इन सेम प्लेन, मतलब तीनों रे एक ही प्लेन पर होंगे. इफ ऑल द रेज सॉरी इफ इंसिडेंट रे इज इन द स्पेस प्लेन, देन नॉर्मल एंड रिफ्लेक्टेड रे आर ऑल्सो इन द स्पेस प्लेन. इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल, सपोज द इंसिडेंट रे इज इन द एयर बट द नॉर्मल इज ड्रॉन ऑन द प्लेन सर्फेस. ओके सपोज सीना, सपोज माई कॉपी इज द मिरर. Okay, so this is ground also. This is the ground. Okay, so this is also one plane, the ground plane. And suppose this is the incident ray. This is the incident ray. Akbar, incident ray. This is the incident ray. Okay, so this is the incident ray. This is the mirror. This is the mirror. This is incident ray. This is reflector ray. Okay, and this is the normal. It is not possible incident ray is in the space, reflected ray is in the space, but normal is in the ground plane. Or incident ray and normal is in the space, but reflected ray in the ground plane. So it is not possible. So all the rays, incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal, they all lie in the same plane. See, if this is the mirror, these three are the incident ray, reflected and normal, they lie in the space plane, same plane. If they lie in this plane, if this is the plane, if incident ray is in the down plane, so though, then all the rays and the normal lie in the same plane also. Okay, so understood? Okay, so this is the first law. They all lie in the same plane. Incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal lie in the same plane. Matlab, tino लाइन एक ही प्लेन पर होंगे. एंड दिस इज नॉट द प्लेन, द सरफेस इज नॉट द प्लेन. आई एम टेलिंग अगेन, सरफेस इज नॉट द प्लेन. ओके, प्लेन मीन्स फ्रॉम वेयर द लाइट कम्स और फ्रॉम वेयर द लाइट रीच. ओके ओके, सेकेंड लॉ. सेकेंड लॉ इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इज इक्वल्स टू एंगल ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन. एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इज इक्वल्स टू एंगल ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. That is the second law. Okay, that means this angle and this angle will be same. Ye dono angle same honge. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. If a ray strikes with 45 degree angle with the normal, if any ray strikes at an angle 45 degree with the normal, then it will reflect. It will reflect at an angle 45 degree with the normal also. If ray strikes at an angle 60, then the reflected angle of reflection will also be 60 degree. Clear everybody? That means this angle and this angle always same. Always same. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. That is the second law of reflection. Clear everybody? So first law, second law. Okay, acha, one thing, one kind of question can come. So listen this question carefully. Suppose this is the incident ray and this is the reflected ray and this is the normal. This is the normal. Okay, this is the incident and reflected. See, ray direction is very important. Incident and reflected. So see, suppose one thing you have given 30 degree angle, a ray incident ray made an angle. The incident ray made an angle 30 degree with the surface. So what is the angle of incidence and what is the angle of reflection? Or what is the angle of reflection? Only you have asked, what is the angle of reflection? Batao. Tell me, how can you do this? How can you do this? This angle is given. That means the angle between surface and the ray. Then you have to find the angle of reflection. Acha, what do we know? The angle of reflection is equal to angle of incidence. Angle of incidence. So first I have to calculate the angle of incidence. So how can we calculate the angle of incidence? See. So we know this total angle is 90 degree. This total angle is 90 degree. because we know normal is perpendicular to the surface, and any perpendicular made 90 degree angle, any perpendicular made 90 degree angle with the surface. So if the total angle is 90 degree and it is 30 degree, so what is the value of this angle? What is the value of this angle? This must be 60 degree. 90 minus 30, actually 90 minus 30. 90 minus 30 is equals to 60 degree. Okay, everybody? 90 minus 30 is equals to 60 degree. So, if angle of incidence is equals to 60 degree, so the angle of reflection will also be 60 degree. Clear? Clear angle of incidence, angle of reflection. I mean, these kind of sums are also clear. Okay? If the angle between ray and surface is given, always subtract from 90. Always subtract from 90 degree, because we know the angle between perpendicular and surface is 90 degree. Okay, so these are the laws of reflection. Okay, and next, how can we form? Image formed by plane mirror. I will discuss in the next class. Okay, so thank you everyone. Please, if you have any problem further, then you ask me. Okay, so bye. Thank you.